Hello there, nerds, and welcome to Go To There, 30 Rock Podcast, a weekly chronological journey through 30 Rock, looking at the jokes, the references, the highs, the lows, and all of the blurbs that come with one of the best shows of the 21st century. As always, I'm your host, Curtis Stone, and joining me is...
David Amick.
And welcome to episode 131, season 7, episode 6, entitled Aunt Phatso vs. Jack Donaghy, originally airing November 15th, 2012. David, if you would, please give us a quick summary slash synopsis of this episode.
Jack Donaghy is very confused when he enters 30 Rock and notices lots of people laughing at the things he's saying, only to learn that Tracy has parried him in his latest Aunt Phatso movie. Meanwhile, Liz needs foot surgery for her bunions, but doesn't trust the show to go on in her absence. However, after Hazel voluntarily starts working as her assistant, she gives her the opportunity to keep things running. Meanwhile, Jenna can't find it in herself to listen to anyone else, a slave to her internal monologue.
Yeah, this was another one of those seasons of an episode that I was like, I don't remember any of this, but I liked it. I did like it. The problem is, two-thirds of it can be summed up by a line Kenneth has, where he's like, Liz once again is having, you know, troubles juggling life and work. And we've seen 100 of those episodes. It's like, move on already. And that is applicable to Liz's storyline, and it's applicable to Jenna's quote-unquote storyline, where Jenna's is a narcissist, and she doesn't care or worry about anybody else. So it's like, I assume they were being... obviously, with the Kenneth line, they are being meta on purpose about Liz's storyline. I don't know, but it's just like, you can kind of read the whole episode, aside from Jack and Tracy's storyline... That, yeah, it's kind of like, yeah, we've done this again and again and again, so I don't know.
That's true, but at least, I mean, I don't know, it did feel like a slightly different way because I don't recall at least where there's a situation where Liz has ever really missed a show or been in danger of it, because the only thing they reference is to something we've never actually seen on the show. So
yeah, the only instance I could think of is when she had that mandated, when she had the sexual harassment report, she had the mandate stay home at work. Stay away from work for like 2 weeks or something, and she was bummed about that because she quote unquote would have to miss a week of work or something like that. But I think she ended up still making it in, so like but no, they do, it is a fresh take on it that she has like a secretary in Hazel, and Hazel's the most ridiculous character always. But I think just Kenneth's line kind of sums up how I sort of feel about this episode, especially the Jenna thing, because I mean, it's such a weak, I wouldn't even consider it a C story. It's just like also a thing happening, and even Kenneth's ending it on I'm only gonna work with, I don't know, I feel like I'm gonna be too hard on this episode, but I don't want to. But the Jack and Tracy stuff is fun because we haven't seen them really interact in a really long time. I have like their own storyline. The first one that really comes to mind is back in season one at the whole country club thing. I'm sure there's more in between that, but I just, that's the first one that comes to mind. It's like, wait, when was the last time Tracy and Jack had a storyline? It was just about them. I feel like it's been a little while. Anyway, what are your thoughts? I feel like I talked too much.
Well, I don't think it was actually the actor who played Josh, but given that Josh has referenced this episode, that means he's appeared in the season as many times as Danny has, so.
Or has at least been referenced.
Yeah. Well, they show quote-unquote Josh running through a scene, which, I mean... I assume if it would have been the actual actor, that we would have clearly seen the face, so yeah. I'm sure it wasn't. But but anyway, yeah, overall, I thought it was fine. I thought it was interesting because we kind of talked a little bit about, like, Tyler Perry movies and stuff a few episodes back, which this is, I mean, I guess I didn't realize, I didn't remember this at all, I remember it was upcoming, because obviously, like, one of the plots is obviously centered around a Tyler Perry-esque, like, Madea type movie.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, I've never actually seen one, so I'm just like trying to like look at like, oh, are there references I'm missing? But it's like all, but I mean, I don't know, I feel like a lot of the references they made were things that like you would just see in a trailer, so I was like, oh, that sounds like, or that looked like something from a trailer, so I wonder like, I don't know how, if they were pretty surface level parodies, or if there were things referenced that I didn't catch that would be more resonant to.
I feel like they were more like 80s movies and like the Big Mama's House and like Clumps, like Nutty Professor. I've seen two Tyler Perry movies, Woman Thou Art Loosed and Diarrhea of a Mad Black Woman.
Oh my god, I thought you said diarrhea for a second.
That's the parody that is out there on the internet.
Yikes.
But, I mean, they were pretty more serious for the most part. Obviously, they have, like, the goofy comedy in Medea and being, like, the outrageous character. But I feel like, especially, like, the shut down the orphanage. I mean, that's a very 80s, like, villain trope. I mean, there's literally, I think, Electric 2, break into Electric Boogaloo. That's literally a plot point in, like, Ski Trip or some 80s movie, like, it's always like the big corporate man's coming to town and he's shutting everything down if we don't raise X amount of dollars to save it. Like, it's just very 80s tropey kind of movie. And I don't remember those plot points.
But I guess that sort of makes sense, like, because if you think of Jack Donaghy as like a Gordon Gekko Wall Street-esque character, that would definitely be an 80s trope. So that makes sense.
So I don't know how faithful they were to, or not faithful, but so much parodying Tyler Perry or... Or just sort of quick. I mean, he literally says he filmed it in a weekend. Yeah. So.
Which is one, because as we talked about, like, Tyler Perry, like, produces those things extremely and films them extremely quickly. Yeah. So.
But no, I did like the Jack and the Tracy stuff. I thought that was a lot of fun. Although it is funny that it wraps up saying, like, well, you didn't even see the ending of the movie, and Jack even has the line, like, well, they're 47 minutes long. So is Jack saying he's not willing to listen or watch them for 47 minutes, or, like, they were so bad that he couldn't stand them for 47 minutes? Although he attended a Philharmonic four-hour orchestra of one song, so his attention span exists. I don't know. He probably just wouldn't watch black cinema.
For 47 minutes. That's probably true.
It's probably too much. And it's two episodes of 30 Rock.
Yikes.
With commercials.
More so, Well,
one with commercials, one without.
There you go.
An hour-long episode of 30 Rock on Hulu.
Without commercial. Anyway.
Without commercial interruption. Any other thoughts before we hop in?
Yeah, Hazel is a funny character, and I think I like her most than most fans of the show generally have, but this was actually a storyline that, I mean... Her being ambitious and wanting to shunt someone out of the way and get her time in the spotlight is, like, a plot that actually has been done for her over and over.
That's
so
true.
Like, and unlike the Liz one, like, there wasn't that much variation because it was just kind of, like, pulling a power move, mm-hmm. doing something to, like, try to get her in the spotlight. So, I mean, it was still funny, but it wasn't... I mean, I guess it worked because... It made sense to fit in with Liz's... Like, you know what I mean? Like, it fit with Liz's storyline that it didn't come totally out of the blue and, like, felt, like... Chunted on in a way that didn't fit, but it just felt a little too similar to the points we've
She's kind of like a one note in that she's literally just looking out for herself.
And to be fair, she hasn't been on much in recent episodes, so
I guess, like, this is kind of the end of that arc for her because I know she comes back because you're not going to fire her and not have some sort of repercussion. So, I mean, this is as far as she was able to get. Well, no, because she got on the live show anyway. But, like, for her to get this far and succeed as well as she did.
And she does have some good one-liners.
Absolutely. I think, yeah. And her manipulation of, like, setting up a pre-recorded, quote-unquote, live feed and, you know, tricking Liz. I mean, Liz is pretty easily tricked, so it's not super hard. But, I mean, like, she played the part well. So I thought she did great. But I could have seen that, yeah, it's kind of like a retread of her character's arc again and again and again. But, yeah. Any other thoughts before we hop in?
Let's hop in.
Tender-footedly Charlie Chaplin our way in, because the bunions.
That too.
All right, so our cold open is going to help set up Jack and Tracy storylines.
What? Hold on. Your name is Jack Donaghy?
That's hilarious.
I beg your pardon. Where is your supervisor?
Oh, you sound just like him. Now say, don't talk to me like that. Don't you know who I am?
I will not say that because you just ruined it.
Jack Donaghy. What pray tell is so funny? I'll give you something to laugh about.
I can't believe he's silly.
Gabe, Google Jack Donaghy and black laughter.
Hold up. You're Jack Donaghy.
Why am I suddenly an object of derision in your community? I've championed diversity on NBC. I mean, we've got football. That's pretty black, right?
I'm laughing because Jack Donaghy is the bad guy from Tracy Jordan's Aunt Phatso movie.
But you can't shut us down. The $25,000 rap competition is in 2 days.
Well, unless you can come up with $25,000 in just 2 days, I'm turning this community center into one of my garbage dumps.
Ooh, damn you, Jack Donaghy. Oh!
$25,000 rap competition in 2 days doesn't actually sound like a very specific reference, so I'm probably missing something there.
There probably is a specific reference. I don't think it would be in a Tyler Perry movie, but... Yeah.
Well, maybe it's like regionals at Glee. Like, there's just some like ridiculous like competition or event that's always happening in a couple days or something, and that's absolutely...
There was, do you remember the movie You Got Served?
I haven't seen it, but I...
You're aware of it? So, yeah, I mean, it's basically... It's like a big breakdancing, like mid-2000s big breakdancing... film. I think there was like 3 or 4 more sequels, all like direct to DVD or whatever, but I think that's a again, it's like a very 80s thing of like, you have X amount of days to come up with X amount of dollars to save X amount of thing. Like, it's just fill in the blank Mad Libs kind of trope from the 80s. But I think that was one of their plot points by the end, was they had to save something and they had to win the big breakdancing competition to win the money to put towards it. That movie's 15 years old now. I can't quite remember the details. But I do remember working at the theater when that movie came out, and it was a blast. Because, like, you know, you go into a movie theater, lights out, it's quiet, you might hear a person coughing. No, literally people dancing, like, in the audience. It was super awesome. It was like, I've never seen anything like this. It was super cool. Yeah. A movie, it's style, no substance kind of movies.
Hell of time. Rude.
Just calls it like I sees them. Ah. So yeah, I don't know if that's a specific reference to a Tyler Perry thing or not.
Does they have to raise $50,000? Do they need $25,000 to pay off Jack Donaghy and $25,000 for the rap competition? Or do they still need $25,000 for the rap competition to begin with?
Oh, man. Anyway, back at 30 Rock, Hazel is ready to shine.
Ah, this is so embarrassing. I accidentally wore my tap shoes today.
Well, might as well do my act. Now, imagine I'm wearing underwear.
Hazel, what did I tell you last time you tried to audition for me?
Oh, who's there? Please don't hurt me. The safe's in my children's room.
You're not getting on the show.
Too bad, Hazel. Looks like everyone's onto your crazy now.
Why don't you make like a woman driver and get lost?
Because I'd rather make like the father I never had and stay.
Well, don't worry about me, Jenna. I've got everyone I need on my side.
Who? Kenneth?
The things he knows about you people. For instance, someone here sucks on old baby wipes to get the alcohol out of them.
Who does that? That's my thing.
And one of these days, Kenneth's gonna tell me something I can use. And then I'll make my move.
Well... Time is running out. Tick tock, Hazel. The clock is ticking.
Well, you know what else ticks? A time bomb. So yeah, Jenna. Tick tock.
Oh, there she is, finally. Liz, where have you been?
I told you like 10 times. I had a doctor's appointment today. My bunions are out of control. The podiatrist said the only possible explanation is that one of my ancestors mated with a dinosaur.
Well, while you were out, we had a little budget snafu. We can't build any new sets, so you're going to have to completely rewrite tomorrow's show so that everything takes place in a farmhouse.
Pete, the budget is your job.
Who are we to say what anything is?
Okay, what did you write after Pete told you we're short?
Liz, we spent a long time trying to come up with a good excuse for why we didn't write anything. But we failed.
I put off this doctor's appointment for months. They had to saw me out of my sneakers. And I need quadruple bunion surgery, but I can't get it because I would have to be off my feet for 3 weeks. And that would require someone else around here to actually step up. I would stomp off right now, but my doctor says I need to walk like this.
Delightful. Charlie Chaplin. You have the mustache and everything.
She really smacks the shit out
she
of
does.
Her first. Her walk is super funny. It is very reminiscent of Charlie Chaplin, though. But
good job, Liz.
You nailed it. The mustache and everything.
Aww. Poor Liz Lemon's mustache. Also, well, not poor, but something Pete, who not only puts the safe in the children's room, but directs the burglar immediately to where his children are instead of trying to save the children. Save me, not the children. That's what he says.
Well, he's got his priorities.
That's true. We know it's not his family.
Well, I mean, he clearly hates his kids. He doesn't.
That's true. That's why he put the safe there, so exactly. He could direct the burglar there.
Exactly. But I feel like Frank's the most of the writing staff. I know we've seen the writing staff in a few episodes, but I feel like he's the most of the writing staff that sort of had speaking roles this season.
Yeah.
Like, he's kind of played just a part of, like, the writer's voice, which isn't a bad thing, and Frank's fun, so I'm not mad at it, but it's just, like, he didn't really need to be in that scene, or I don't know. It's just... All right.
They had to fill another 20 seconds.
Yep. Had to give a reason for Liz to explain why she can't be on her feet if she gets the surgery.
I get that too.
Totally fine. Meanwhile, in Tracy's office, Jack is reviewing the evidence against him. And Aunt Phatso.
Phatso.
What's the matter, Jack Donaghy? Did somebody accidentally swing a freaking ball into the...
Lennon, do you think I'm a villain?
Well, I have heard you say, guard, seize him.
I was at a Knicks game. They needed to stop the clock. Why are you limping? A foot illness or fell running for food?
I need bunion surgery, but I can't get bunion surgery because I have to do everything around here.
No, you choose to do everything around here. You need an assistant.
What? No. I mean, I can always use Ceree, although the one time I did send her on an errand, she met some guy who flew her to Paris, and then she started modeling, and then she ended up being the reason why the French soccer team did so badly in the 2010 World Cup.
Hire someone. Someone dedicated to making your life easier.
I don't know.
You want to start a family, you have to prioritize. How can you take care of a child if you can't take care of your own feet?
Hey, Grizz. Hey, .com. Get me a black coffee, by which I mean a sun-kissed.
How could you think we're grizzin.com?
Because I don't see race, you white bastards.
Tracy, would you care to explain this?
What, pray tell, is so funny?
Jack Donaghy, don't you know in this neighborhood you got to take your ties with you?
Then, Phatso, you're fired. You're all fired.
What is this?
That's Tracy Jordan's Aunt Phatso goes to the hospitals, goes to jail.
When did you make a movie?
4th of July weekend. I wrote, directed, and did all the makeup myself.
Oh, it's terrible.
We made $50 million in Atlanta.
That man is portraying me.
That's Leslie Van Bondervan. He used to be on Knott's Landing.
Our twin is dead. Unacceptable. After all I've done for you, I brought you back from the dead and revived your career. And this is how you thank me?
You respect me, and you respect these movies.
I want every DVD of this movie removed from stores, burned, and melted into a statue of you apologizing to me.
I will do no such thing. The only statue that movie will be turned into is an NAACP Shame Award.
Hey, is there another one of these coming out? Because I think I saw an ad for it in Urban Butts magazine. They have an excellent word jumble.
The new movie is called Tracy Jordan's Aunt Phatso's Jack Donaghy's We At It Again.
Oh, you will not release that movie.
You can't order me around. Who do you think I am, Liz Lemon?
I will not have you talk to me like I'm some kind of Liz Lemon.
Whatever. I'll speak at both your funerals.
Typical Jack Donaghy, giving me no respect. I'm the CEO of my own company. I'm rich. I'm just like you.
Just like me. I went to Princeton.
I neglected a tiger.
I'm on the board of the New York Philharmonic.
I'm friends with Philharmonic, the worst rapper of all time.
And I'm your boss. I own you. Think about that during your five-night appearance on Watch What Happens Live.
No! Here you go, and it's so catty!
And that's just the beginning. If you don't take care of this, you're fired. You're all fired.
She's a verb.
Three thoughts on that scene. First, I love all the possessive references in the title. So, what Tracy Jordan's Aunt Phatso's goes to hospitals, goes to jail, and then Tracy Jordan or Aunt Phatso's Jack Donaghy's we at it again. It's funny. Second, I feel like it's out of character for Liz to find those funny. Like, I feel like she would be incredibly snobbish about how terrible they are. Based on what else we know about her.
Yeah, but we've seen her laugh at dumb things, too.
That's true.
So.
But it just, I don't know, it didn't. Yeah. It struck me as slightly out of...
Well, did she did say they're terrible. So, like, she wasn't praising
them. That's true.
But, yeah. Also, like, He's super proud about it making like $50 million in Atlanta. That's good, right? I mean, if that's your limited
I mean,
release,
if it made $50 million in the whole country based on the budget for those, that would be pretty good. So, yeah. I know, I think the joke, well, I mean, yeah, I guess the joke is that, like, I mean, there's a very specific audience for those.
Tyler Perry, is he from Atlanta? Or I know he did a lot of his work.
I mean,
he
I don't
does
know
a lot
like,
of his work now out of
for
it.
Sure.
Well, a lot of
yeah, his studios are there. I don't know. I mean, I don't know. I'm not sure if he's from there originally. He might be, but he definitely does a lot of production. So, is there some Generalissimo reference in that soap opera scene? Because wasn't the plot of that, I mean, that was another soap opera where there was a twin that Alec Baldwin was playing the character. So, like, is there...
I guess
there's... Is there a direct reference there, or is it just, like, kind of, like, a more, like, allusion or whatever to that?
Well, so Alec Baldwin did get his start on Knots Landing, so it's obviously not
okay,
that.
Okay.
But it is funny that, yes, that he... He did have a lookalike in the Generalissimo episode, but now he's got a lookalike here in Leslie Van Warren, who does it, he didn't even know about. So
Leslie Van Warren?
Was it? Was it
Vander... Leslie Van Warren played Miss Scarlet in The Clue.
Oh, my God.
No, yeah. So
the fact that you know that is interesting, because that's such a weird name to bring up apropos of nothing, because it's... Anyway.
But that was Leslie Van Vander...
Van Buren or something. Van, yeah, anyway.
Anyway.
So now Jack Donaghy has two other doppelgangers, the Generalissimo, and now this guy, who is unaware of. But yeah, I think it's really piggybacking on the fact that he was on Knots Landing when he got started.
Ah, okay.
But it is funny that, yes, he now has another person that looks just like him.
On a soap opera.
On a soap opera.
With a twin.
And in acting. Yeah. So it's a shame Jack didn't go into acting. He might have been a success. But yeah, I like the thing with the Tracy and the Jack arguing. As I feel like Tracy, if they're arguing quote-unquote accomplishments, Tracy wins when he outright says, I'm the CEO of my own company. Because that's something that Jack has been trying
that's
to do
true.
For 7 years. Well, more than that, but in the time we've seen him trying to do it in 7 years. And Tracy did it in a year because he just created his own company. But yeah, them bickering about... Their achievements are pretty great. The neglect there to Tiger. Princeton's not the Tigers, are they?
Yeah.
Oh,
Tigers
they are. Okay.
Mascot, yeah.
Okay. That makes the joke a little bit funnier than me.
Yeah.
Than I thought. All right. So Kenneth and Hazel are having lunch, I guess, or a break. Anyway, and Kenneth gives them all the dirty details about the goings on at TGS.
So tell me about your day, Kevin. I mean, Todd.
Well, this morning, Miss Lemon had one of her meltdowns.
Really? About what?
Well, because she can't balance work and personal life. But I mean, after 7 years and hundreds of these episodes, it's like, let's move on.
Liz needs help. She needs someone who's ambitious and talented and humble and a liar. That's where Hazel comes in. Oh, let me hang those up for you. You've got better things to do, you genius.
Okay, thanks.
Oh, also, I put all the new promos on your computer, and I wasn't sure how you take your coffee. So, mouth or enema?
What's going on here, Hazel? Oh,
you need help. I know you're trying to get pregnant because I think about it all the time. You on top, your hair whipping around. But what if you do have a kid and you have to leave work because your daughter shot her choir teacher's husband? I mean, that's the kind of stuff my mom had to deal with.
Wow, okay, well, I'm just not sure that I'm comfortable. Did you get me a second mini fridge?
No, I got you a mini freezer full of candy bars so cold they'll crack your jaw, you bitch. Shh.
I didn't say anything.
Shh. Look, I want to help. You're my hero. Just give me a chance. Sisters helping sisters, glass ceiling, legitimate rape.
Okay, Hazel, I'm going to get my foot surgery, and if you can be my eyes and ears while I'm stuck on the couch, you've got the job.
Great. Now, if it's okay with you, I am going to go wash your sweatshirt.
You got it unstuck from the chair.
Here we go.
Hazel, thank you for taking care of everything. I can't believe you got my health plan to cover all this.
Oh, you just need to know what to say to them. Like their children's names and what they wore to school today.
Oh. Oh, will you send Frank in? I want to see what they wrote to fill the fifth act.
Or, since I'm here to help, maybe I could fill the time. I still know my rhythmic gymnastics routine. I was good until I hit puberty and the coaches said I got too pregnant.
Are you kidding? I'm not going to put you on the show.
Lemon, a word?
Hey, guy! You can't just walk in here whenever you want. How can I help you?
So, Lemon has an assistant. Excellent. Jack Donaghy to see Liz Lemon.
A Mr. Donaghy here for you.
Get off this channel. This is a military frequency.
Okay. You can go.
So you got your surgery and the world hasn't ended.
I think I can do this, Jack. All of it. I mean, right now my feet are kind of like babies. I have to swaddle them and they need ointment and like six times a day brown stuff comes out of them. You beautiful babies. Yes, you are.
Look, Lemon, I need some advice. Tracy is actually trying to fight back. He ruined a wonderful evening at the Philharmonic, paying them to play the same song over and over again for hours. I can't remember what it was, but the point is, the man is totally irrational.
You know what? Tracy's right. You two are a lot alike.
I beg your pardon.
You're both stubborn, you're rich, you think you're right all the time. You want to prove that you're not like Tracy? Let it go.
Or crush him and prove you both wrong. Get two birds with one stone, like when I used Mick Jagger to lure Roger McGuinn and David Crosby to my birthday party.
Listen to yourself. You sound exactly like Tracy.
I like Hazel's just dominance over Jack and pushing him out. Like, I don't know if he's been mistreated like that, or not mistreated, but treated like that in a long time since we've seen
him. By a woman, nonetheless.
By a page, nonetheless, of all people.
Although I am glad that someone has figured out how to work the healthcare insurance.
You just gotta know
system.
The children's names and what they wore to school that day. If only we knew that. Man, we could scam a lot of people. But it's so weird to, I don't know if you, I'm sure you've seen them at this point. I feel like it's like an old quote-unquote hack, but like when you get your bill from the hospital, you basically get, you ask for a itemized bill, and you're able then to dispute a lot of those charges and get your bill down considerably. Because they're like, if you don't look at it, they'll charge you for literally anything that they do, they can charge you for. But if you get an itemized bill and sort of call about it, you can like argue a lot of those charges either down or off of your bill, which is like horrendous. Cause I think until in the last 10 years, that wasn't really like known that you could do that, or you should probably do that. But
I don't know.
Like, I'm glad that it's now more public knowledge that you can question like, yeah, you charged me for a Band-Aid, or like, it's just like things like that. Anyway, yeah, just gotta scam the system. It's not there to help you.
Also, how's
insurance? Insurance does not care about you in any way. Just FYI.
Yeah, right, because it's a business.
Yeah.
Also, how? I mean, I'm not surprised that Hazel is tapping into a military frequency, but
why haven't they?
Why? How? And what?
Yeah. What is she using?
Yeah.
Why does she still have it? Why have they not stopped her? There's a lot of questions there.
I mean, maybe she uses it to track people.
Oh, definitely. But why haven't they stopped her yet? I guess is the question.
Yeah, she's too intimidating.
That's true. She did just push around Jack Donaghy. No one does that. Kenneth finds Jenna, who is trying to offset Hazel's wickedness and becomes a lending ear for Kenneth. Meanwhile, in Jack's office, he's ready to shut down Tracy's new movie.
Ah, Tracy, thank you for coming. Please, have a seat.
No, thank you. I prefer to lie down.
These are my lawyers. One is German, one is Japanese. And you don't bring these guys together to play patty cake. This is war.
Bad news, Jack. War's my favorite card game, and I win about half the time.
Here's the rub, Tracy. Because you were reckless enough to name your businessman villain Jack Donaghy, I can sue you for libel. I'm gonna take every penny you have.
Not the ones I've swallowed.
We'll see about that.
Dude, it's not liable. Everything Jack Donaghy does in the movie, I've seen you do it in real life.
Really? When have you seen me do something like this?
You're a menace, Aunt Phatso, but now that I'm on the city council, I'm canceling your urban youth program.
Oh, Lord! What? You did cancel a program for urban youth. It was my Saturday morning kids show. Uncle Tracy's Black Teletubbies ripoff.
I canceled it because, like you, it was overly sexual and impossible to understand.
Grab a loser!
Fine. I've technically canceled an urban children's program. But what about this assault on my good name?
Not so fast, you crone. I bought all the wheelchair ramps in this city, and I'm turning them into more profitable stairs.
When have I ever verbally accosted an old woman in a wheelchair?
Liz Lemon, 20 minutes ago.
Another technicality. But the climax of this monstrosity...
Das ist what she said.
...is when Jack Donaghy shuts down an orphanage. And I have never shut down an orphanage.
You're right. I put that in just to have a part in there for a little girl in my movie. I'm Willow Smithing my daughter. Her album drops next week.
Christmas. Licky.
This is libel, Tracy. I win. Checkmate, game, set, match, rumbly-goo. Which is what you say when you win in polo.
Yeah, that, the lawyer joke, like, you explained off mic, because it's a war reference. They were axes of power. It just feels like they weren't needed. I feel like he could have made that joke about don't let me bring in my lawyers, one who's German and one who's Japanese, because this is going to be war. Like, you could make that joke without them being...
But then who would say that's what she said?
I don't know, have someone else there to say it? I don't know, like...
Jonathan, where'd Jonathan go? We haven't seen him in a while.
Came one or two episodes. Gabe's been in the season more than Jonathan, although Jonathan has had more lines than Gabe. I don't know, it was just such a weird joke for the lawyers to be there.
Also, someone's not ADA compliant, buying up all the wheelchair ramps in the city to convert to...
Yeah,
I mean, it's funny because that joke is so stupid, but I would love to know how stairs are more profitable than...
Well, I guess...
Or through that way.
Because it costs more concrete to build the leveled stairs than it would a straight incline.
But it costs more to tear down what's already existing than build something on top of it.
So, but it's good for the economy because you're paying someone to tear down the ramp and you're paying someone else to put the stairs in.
Yes, when you're paying others, that's less profit.
But it's good for the economy. Yeah, I don't know. It doesn't make... I mean, and that
was
just never...
It's just absurd. No, it's just supposed to be absurd. But so I'm just trying to picture.
Although, like, if he is the one behind all that, I can't imagine he would literally go to the people's faces and be like, "I'm tearing these all down. I'm the one responsible." They would hide behind, like, bureaucracy and politics. Like, they wouldn't out and outright say, "I'm the one doing this to you, you old bag." Like, God, how awful. And also the Willow Smith joke, which... It's timely at this time, but I think 10 years removed, it's kind of like, Willow Smith, like, what has she done lately? Like, I feel like Jaden Smith is far more topical as a kid than Willow. Like, she had the hair back and forth.
Right. Well, no, I mean, I feel like she's on the verge of a music breakthrough because she, like, I don't know, she just put out a single recently that's like, it's like she's moving into more of like...
Pop punk.
Pop punk, like alt R&B type image, which it's actually surprisingly good. Like, I listened to it and I was like, it was much better than I would have guessed. Based, I mean, not that I know that much about her past
music. Smith has talent. Why wouldn't his daughter?
Well, no, that's true.
Talent is genetic.
That's true, but she put out an album like several years ago that I remember hearing something from. It's like, I don't know. But anyway, so I wouldn't be surprised she actually does have a music breakthrough in the near future. Mm. But that song that Tracy's baby does is quite the banger.
Something. We only get two words out of it. Everything else is bleeps, but she's okay. She's having a good time. That's what's important. As long as they're having fun, that's what's important. But it's fun to see Virginia again because we haven't seen her since Queen of Jordan. So she gets her time to shine. So as the show is about to start, Hazel is ready to take care of everything and reassures Liz that she can handle it.
Uh-oh, somebody needs to be changed.
Need anything else, boss man?
I guess just bring in the wheelchair so you can roll me down to the floor for the show.
What?
No, Liz. You had surgery this morning.
Sure, but I have to be there.
Oh, I would slap you if I didn't think it would lead to a kiss. This is about priorities. What if those feet were real babies? Would you walk on them to work? What kind of mother are you, you beautiful monster?
Hazel, I have missed one show in 7 years, and it did not go well.
Ah! Josh, help me!
You're not gonna miss the show. You're gonna watch it on the feed, baby girl. Idiot. I'll be next to Pete the whole time, and if there's an emergency, your wheelchair's right outside.
Well, I guess I could work.
Let me be your eyes on set. Although I can never match that amazing color.
Chris calls it old-timey football.
Hazel's a woman on a mission.
I have to be honest, it didn't go the way I thought it was, because when Liz tells her to put her in the wheelchair and wheel her down to the floor, it's like, oh, this is going to be like an All About Eve reference or like parody in some way, which doesn't end up happening at all. Like, I thought it was going to be just some like Hazel like pushing Liz, like, you know, like down the stairs in the wheelchair or whatever. But nope, it goes in a totally different direction, which is actually, I guess, sort of more interesting, because the All About Eve thing has been obviously been done a gazillion times. So just like she destroys the wheelchair and puts in a fake tape, which is a fun way to fool Liz.
Yeah, no, it is. I mean, I feel like I've seen the All About Eve homage and reference many times, but I've never seen.
What about parodied?
Probably parodied as well. All three, all of the above. But yeah, I think that's where I think like the mischievous and the fun of Hazel comes in, is that she was like, because like she's not stupid, she's not a dumb character, she's not like Kenneth, she's not naive, she is manipulative.
She's just sociopathic in her self advancement.
But she's like really smart about it, so it's like she knows how to get ahead. She's just doing it all for the wrong reasons and all in the wrong ways. But yeah, but has that trick of like looping video? I guess it's not the case here, but like this is like replaying an old tape, but like looping video and playing back old tape, that's been done before. But has it been done before Speed? Because I feel like Speed either reintroduced that as an idea or really cemented it as like I don't want to say trope, because I've used that word a lot this time, but like as an idea, like a writing idea. Because I know you haven't seen Speed.
Because, that's correct.
You know, it's a good movie, but. Like one of the tricks that they do in that is because the bus has a camera on it, so Dennis Hopper character can see what's going on. They find that and they I can't quite remember how they do it, but they somehow find the feed and they just continuously loop it to make it look like they're not doing anything to like stop the bomb from going off. But I feel like since then it's been done more. I don't know. Anyway, I asked the wrong person that question.
You most certainly
so
did.
I apologize.
But you'd think Hazel would have at least watched through the video and noticed that like Liz herself is very prominently in the fake tape.
Also, like where does it aimed at? It looks like it's aimed like middle of the stage. It doesn't look like it's aimed like from a audience member's point of view. It looks like it's aimed like backstage, and I'm not sure.
Well,
like,
she,
I guess the
Hazel does say, "I'll be standing with Pete right here," so it must be in a place where Pete and Liz normally stand during the as the show is going on.
Yeah. So. All right. Interesting. Speaking of looped footage, or rather played back footage, Liz learns the secret of Hazel's intentions.
5 minutes to air. 5 minutes.
Wow, this is really working. Hey, is that me? Okay, no, that can't be. Oh, brother, that's me! It's an old show? Son of a...
Well, this email is from Liz.
Duh. Now, for my act, I'm gonna need a tarp because the first three rows will get wet.
Why are my arms so weak? It's like I did that push-up last year for nothing.
And 2 minutes to air. 2 minutes.
I'm sorry, babies.
I have your email.
P-Dog, let's use Hazel in the cold open. Don't call me about this. Catch on the flippy floppy. That's you.
You people killed my foot babies. My foot babies died because of this show.
You're fired. You can't fire me. You don't even know my real name.
Get out. Now. Oh!
Did you just fire my girlfriend?
She's crazy, Kenneth.
No, she's not. Ms. Maroney knows the real Hazel. Tell them what I told you.
Oh, God. What do I do? Help me. Me. This one's on you, bitch.
Were you not listening?
I think a song right now.
That's it! From now on, my relationship with all of you is strictly professional. We are no longer friends. I am just a coworker who would do anything for any of you at any time. Nothing more!
And we're live in 3, 2.
Oh, yeah. They didn't write anything.
That's such a great ending to that scene and story, because I kind of forgot that that was a reason that they hadn't done anything, is because they were all worried about what excuses they could make up. That's so funny.
And they still never did.
They never did. And but you can't even blame Liz for that, because she wasn't there to be on top of them. She had surgery.
Yeah.
So it's like, she couldn't have done anything. It's so funny. Yeah. Hazel's gone. She's fired.
Rhythmic gymnasticing her way off screen.
Yeah, that was a nice touch. Like, she's like, all right, well, I'm fine. I'm still going to get my time in. She's doing it for just a small amount of the audience, though. That was funny.
Well, you never... There can be 100 people in a crowd and 99 of them don't believe you, but all you need is one give you your big break. Yep. So who knows? There could be some producer in the audience.
Or some Olympian that sees you and says...
Exactly. The Olympics are upcoming, Hazel.
Come to Tokyo with me. But yeah, so we know Hazel's not done. We'll see her again, but seems like her time at 30 Rock is tick-tocking away.
Oh, I really like the sound editing of the scene of like Jenna's internal monologue where she's like arguing with herself, and like the one half or whatever herself just like drives off into the...
You know, this is another like allusion to 30 Rock being a live-action cartoon, because I've only seen that joke in a cartoon of like... Yeah. Your head or whatever, just someone or someone running off screen and like getting in a car and peeling out is the only time you see. So it's like, I think 30 Rock's one of the few instances I've ever, probably the only instance I've ever seen a live action show make that joke. Cause how else do you explain it in an ordinary sitcom? Like, wait a minute, why did their brain just peel out? So kudos. Also, Liz's email, quote unquote, Liz's email, P-Dog, flippy floppy.
Yeah, on his flip phone.
On his flip phone. Like, all right, Pete, come on, get in the, 2000s, not even the 2010s, just get a more modern phone. I could see Liz sending an email like that, especially see you on the flippy floppy.
Yikes.
Well, we're coming up on the finale. Tracy and Jack have reached an agreement.
Tracy, this is a surprise. I thought you'd be at home licking your wounds.
No, that's why they put that cone on me. I just wanted to give you this.
You are cordially invited to attend the premiere of Tracy Jordan's Aunt Phatso's Jack Donaghy's We At It Again. A percentage of the film's profits will go to support the Knuckle Beach Orphanage. I don't understand.
Without that money, the orphanage is going to have to close.
So if I shut down the movie, I actually will close down an orphanage, which means the movie isn't libelous, which means I can't shut down the movie. That's genius. You win, Tracy. You bested Jack Donaghy.
Now you finally respect me. And that's all I ever wanted.
I really can't stop you from portraying me as the villain in your films.
What? Come on. Did you not watch the whole movie, Jackie D?
Well, it's 47 minutes long.
In the end, Jack Donaghy is not the villain.
You win, Aunt Phatso. You bested Jack Donaghy.
Now you finally respect me, and that's all I ever wanted. Except maybe that hot little body of yours.
Great Caesar's ghost!
Oh, baby. I would think sure is playing out just like the movie.
Oh, look, little it's Liz.
Well, my feet are ruined. The show was an embarrassment, but I learned something super fun. I will never be able to have a family and work at TGS. It's just not possible. So what do I do?
Don't ask me. Tracy's the genius here.
Okay, well, Trey, I'm scared. Do I give up on my dream job, something I've worked my whole life to build? Or do I give up on my dream of having a family?
Well, as a wise woman once told me, respect these boobies!
Seriously, though, what am I going to do?
What are you going to do, Liz Lemon? Your time is ticking, too.
Can women really ever have it all?
Name one show that's proven that right.
Glee.
I don't think that's true.
I don't know. It's been a long time since I've seen it, and I never watched more than 1.5 to 2 seasons.
Yeah, I don't think I went any further than... Did I finish season 2? I don't know.
Mary Tyler Moore Show. There we go. That's the definitive Can She Have It All.
That show's super good. That show's good.
Yeah.
That
is a really strong show. Is it still on Hulu?
It might be. I don't
know. It was at one point.
That's how I
was. Oh, maybe it was CBS. So maybe, yeah, but
it might have moved.
Maybe at Paramount Plus now.
Yeah. I love Lucy still on Hulu, though. So who knows? Mary Tyler Moore may still be there.
I'll watch it one of these days.
It's so good. It has one of the best finales ever. But yeah, that's Aunt Phatso versus Jack Donaghy.
Aunt Phatso versus Jack Donaghy's 30 Rocks. Aunt Phatso versus Jack Donaghy.
Exactly. But yeah, Liz still doesn't know what she's gonna do, and I don't think they treated her the best in just laughing at her pain, literally and figuratively.
No, she was laughing at it too.
I think she was laughing through the pain though, and it only lasted a little while. But there's also some sexual tension there between Tracy and Jack. Thankfully, it didn't go anywhere, because...
Will they or won't they?
Hopefully, they never will. I'm all for man-on-man, but not those two men. They don't look like they'd be into it.
Ageist.
I didn't say anything about their age.
Ageist.
All right. Final thoughts on 30 Rock's Aunt Phatso's versus Jack Donaghy before we say adieu?
Yeah. I revised what I said at the beginning, like with Hazel, even though it is another a very similar storyline for her, she does have, watching again, she does have so many good one-liners that it still works.
Yeah, I feel like it's retreading the character, but it's still fresh and fun, that it doesn't feel too much or anything. Again, just the weak part is Jenna's quote-unquote storyline, and Liz, again, doing a storyline of Can She Have It All, but all in all, it's still a super fun episode. I'm looking forward to next week's, because next week's a big life change for Liz and Chris, where they're going to get married.
Spoiler alert!
As always, thank you for joining us on Go To There. If you like what we're doing, rating, reviewing, all that fun stuff, it's going to be the best way to help us out. Otherwise, we will see you in next week's episode, episode 132, season 7, episode 7, entitled Mazel Tov, Dummies! David, take us out.
See you next time.
Lemon, a word?
Hey, guy! You can't just walk in here whenever you want.